They're one of those groups that you don't like, you love. You know, you either you haven't heard of them, but if you're into them, you don't just say, oh, they're pretty good. You know, anyone who's into Blue Nile will go, oh, and, you know, sharp intake of breath.
They're interested in capturing a moment, not a social moment necessarily, but a moment's feeling. They're not interested in fashion, they're not interested in describing the ins and outs of the culture that we're in, which pop music has become very good at and adept and perhaps rather facile at. They're interested in just taking fractional snapshots of a moment's feeling, looking out of a window, walking down a street.
Hat's record has to be one of the 20 best albums ever made. There's just something about it that even if the Blue Nile had not done an album before and didn't do one after, if it was just left as a single document of what they're about, I think it would be a perfect statement. Sometimes
people see the Blue Nile thing as simply a frame for the extraordinary, rather limited but concentrated voice. I don't actually. I see the voice as an instrumental part of the package, the structure. And I think he probably sees it as that as well, which is why he's sort of strangely over-modest about his singing.
Les Gaston's a very incredibly dignified song, just lyrically so strong. He just sings it. And the third verse, when Paul really kind of starts to let rip vocally, you almost feel he's not going to make the notes.
Statement about romantic heartbreak. The whole album is so, you just get the strongest feeling of some guy who's fallen in love with this beautiful woman and just, it's just not happening. He knows he hasn't got what it takes to sort of win her ultimately. And as albums go, I think Hats is just 100% cinematic.
I think the gap between the albums was this struggle for perfection, this quest for perfection that they sort of persevere with to the detriment of their career, you know, I use the word loosely. But again, I think it worked for them among their fans, among those of us that love them. The fact that there was such a long gap between albums meant that the anticipation and wait was intense. And each one became a precious thing. You certainly didn't have overkill, you had underkill.
Space in his songs for the listener to move in. You know, I think all good songwriters leave plenty of space. Family life, I think you feel as though every word has been weighed up. You know, I almost have this sort of image of some scales, and you know, he just was weighing every word and every note for, I could imagine, for months, until there's just no meat that isn't necessary. It's just like the perfect stark song.
Feel of nostalgia about it. It's just incredibly moving. You're not quite sure why or when or where, but it makes you think of your own childhood. I think if there's any justice, they will be remembered, you know, as long as music is remembered, as long as, I was going to say rock music, but it, again, you know, it's not rock music, it's not pop music, it's simply the Blue Nile, and the Blue Nile are unique and wonderful.
I wouldn't dare try and second guess where Paul Buchanan's going to go next. I just live with the anticipation, as indeed I think all Blue Nile fans do, of, you know, where are these guys going to take us this time? And I'm sure it'll be worth it. I mean, we're having our usual wait, but then that's part of being a Blue Nile fan, waiting.